If you could see infrared light, you would see a world of temperatures and not color. Every object that has temperature radiates in the infrared part of the spectrum. But can we see infrared? First, let me tell you a story. The story of the discovery of infrared. In 1800s, William Herschel set up an experiment in which sunlight was passed through a slit and then through a prism, forming a spectrum on his table. He arranged three thermometers in such a way that the central one could be placed at different points in the spectrum. The other two were positioned on either side to act as controls. So what does control mean then? Herschel needed to show that any effect he saw was due to the light falling on the central thermometer. The control thermometers eliminated any general heating effect on the thermometers. Herschel made repeated measurements by placing the thermometer bulb at different parts of the spectrum. In each, he observed a temperature rise. He concluded that the red rays of the sunlight have a greater heating effect. As the sun moved across the sky, the spectrum moved across the table. When the thermometer was just beyond the red end of the spectrum, Herschel noticed that the temperature was even higher than before. He concluded that there were invisible rays coming from the sun and refracted by the prism beyond the red end of the spectrum. This was the first time someone had measured infrared. Again, we come back to the question, can we see infrared light? Scientists at Washington University School of Medicine were happy to be working with a powerful new infrared laser. Where they saw an odd thing happening, people around the lab were seeing flashes of green light when the laser was on. The flashes disappeared whenever the laser was turned off. How could people, without even trying, see infrared light? And why was the light green? An international team of scientists decided to experiment with people and lasers. They used different infrared lasers to flash light at people. The flashes were carefully calculated so that each flash would give the same amount of photons streaming towards their eyes. But those photons could come in different intervals of time. A short amount of time meant infrared photons came in a flood. A long amount of time allowed the photons to trickle through the subject's retina. Under the right circumstances, humans can see infrared. Inside a human's eye, there are photopigments that change their structure when they get hit by a photon. The part of the photopigment that changes its structure is called the chromophore. It is shackled to what's called an opsin. Give a chromophore just the right amount of energy and it changes its structure. The only photons with the right amount of energy to change the structure of a human chromophore is in the range of 390 to 720 nanometers of wavelength. Infrared in the 1000 nanometer wavelength range are too long and have too low energy to knock out a chromophore to change its shape. But if a huge amount of infrared photons flooded the eye at a very short period of time, there's a possibility two infrared photons could hit the chromophore at the same time. Their combined energy is enough to change the structure of the chromophore and allow people to see what otherwise they couldn't. When the energies of 2000 nanometer photon combine, their energies add up to around a photon having 500 nanometer wavelength, which is in the green range of the visible spectrum. So infrared light, if concentrated enough, could leave us see green light. So this was it for today. Thanks for watching, guys, and thanks for 250 subscribers, guys. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Share our video if you want to. Subscribe to our channel for future videos. If you want our social networking links, they are here or in the description. If you want to watch our previous videos, you can click here or here. And as always, guys, stay curious, stay awesome.